Coming up where you can see them. It was funny, at first he didn't want to fight.
Yeah, I've had them like that in the past where they'll just, you know, I think they don't know they're hooked.
Like a striper back home, actually, at
it's
first.
Hobby.
Track here in a minute.
Five or six? It was five.
Five albies.
I probably hooked seven or eight, seven probably. Had numerous follows on the swimmers and stuff, which had some difficulty getting hooked up. I'd be yelling, slam!
Does that happen very often?
This time of year, yeah, you get a good shot at it. Other times of the year, no, it's very tough. Yeah, well, we dropped off to 23 feet, so. Oh, That's why. He rolled on it and snagged. So he's gonna be. He's like towing in a log.
Yeah.
When they can shut their mouth, they fight really hard. If you can control their face.
That's a bluefish.
Yeah, that's a bluefish. See the teeth?
Yeah. Notice those other reels, the drag was tighter than this one, so quite a bit.
Yeah, so you can give it. You seem pretty good though, right there.
Now.
Charging it.
Charge, boy.
That center hook, look at that.
Yeah.
I'll bet you he was all of 11, if not 12 pounds. Here's a little tip for you. For years, I've been putting floats on my tools and things like that to prevent them from going to the bottom of the drink if I happen to drop them overboard. You know, like the heavy boga, it'll be pretty neutral buoyant and suspend in the water, so at least you can retrieve it. And, you know, the pliers and knives and things like that, they'll definitely float so you can retrieve them easily. So that's a great tip for you. Put some floats on your tools and keep them safe.